Hi friends, welcome to UGC NET online pre-coaching. Myself SP Sujan, Assistant Professor and HOD, Department of Computer Science, Government First Grade Women's College for Jamkandi. Today I will discuss KSET December 2017 Computer Science Questions conducted by Mysore University, Karnataka. Actually, in Computer Science, every NET or SET exams, you will get 5 to 6 questions. In KSET also, you got 6 questions. In out of 6 questions, one question based on memory, one question based on conversion, one question based on abbreviation, one question based on internet. So definitely you will get 4 questions based on 4 topics. One question may be abbreviation, maybe you will get 2 questions, sometime internet you will get 2 questions, sometime conversion maybe get 2 to 3 questions. So total 5 to 6 questions based on computer science. Repeatedly I am telling you, which one you will get a definite questions with a particular topic, you should be perfect that one. So we'll go for one by one. There are 6 questions. In this first question, they asked 4 GB is equal to 32 megabyte or 2^30 bytes or 2^32 bytes or 2^10 terabytes. Before solving this question, you should know the memory, how exactly will storage units in computer science. So please perfect this question, because every exam, every NET or SET exams, you will get one question, definitely 2 marks is fixed. So smallest individual element, and means small element, storage element in computer science is either 0 or 1, binary numbers. So next combination of 4 bits we'll call as a 4 bits we'll call as a nibble. So 8 bits, combination of 8 bits we'll call as a byte. So combination of 1024 bytes, means 1 byte is equal to 8 bits, 1024 bytes is 1 kilobyte, means what, 1024 into 8, that is number of bits in kilobytes. Similarly, megabyte, 1024 kilobytes, what is your KB, 1024 bytes, so 2^10 actually, 1024, this is 2^10, 2^20 bytes you may, in simply you may call. So similar, exactly this is a memory hierarchy, 1 byte is equal to 8 bits. Actual memory in a computer stores like this, 1 bit takes 1 position. So 8 bits, combination of 8 bits will call as a 1 byte. So if you combine 4 bytes is called as a nibble. So combination of 1024 bytes is 1 kilobyte. So 1024 kilobytes is equal to 1 megabyte, 1024 megabytes is equal to 1 gigabyte, and 1024 gigabytes is equal to 1 terabyte. So please remember this chart and remember this one, because every time you will get one question. So now look at how to solve this question. This is, one second I will explain. 1, 0 or 1, so smallest bit in computer. 1 word represents 32 bits, means word length, that is depends on the size of the register limit. Now we'll go for 1 kilobyte is equal to 2^10 bytes. So 1 gigabyte is equal to 2^10 megabytes. What is your megabyte? 2^10 gigabytes. So 2^10 kilobytes. So means 2^10 base is same, add powers, 2^20 kilobytes. Now what is your 1 kilobyte? 1 kilobyte is 2^10. So 2^20 plus into 2^10, base are same, add powers, 2^30 bytes, means 1 gigabyte is equal to 2^30 bytes. Okay, just remember this one. Now we'll solve this question. The given option is 4 GB is equal to 4 GB equal to 4 into 1 MB, means 4 GB is equal to 4 gigabyte. So let us assume, what is your 4 into MB? Okay, so what is your MB? 1024 kilobyte. Okay, means 1 gigabyte is equal to, you may substitute directly, what is your 4? 2^2 into megabyte. What is your megabyte? 2^30 bytes. Just look at, 1 gigabyte is equal to 2^30 bytes. Okay, So gigabyte is equal to 2 raised to 30 bytes into 2 raised to 2, because it is 4. They asked here 1 gigabyte is equal to 2 raised to 30 bytes. So 4 gigabyte is equal to 4. What is 4? 2 to the power 2. So base are same, add powers. So you'll get 2 raised to 32 bytes. So simple calculation, don't be confused. That is 1 GB, just this one. 1 GB is equal to 2 raised to 10 megabytes, 2 raised to 10, 2 raised to 20 kilobytes, 2 raised to 30 bytes. 1 GB is exactly this one, means division. This is 1 kilobit is equal to 2 raised to 10, actually megabytes. 1 megabyte is equal to 2 raised to 20 kilobytes. So 2 raised to 20 kilobytes is equal to 2 raised to 30 bytes. This one. So the option C is right answer for this question. Don't be confused. 2 raised to 30 bytes of memory. So look at second one. Which of the following is correct? This is exactly same question repeated in November 2017 NET question. Small change actually. We'll look at 16 decimal is equal to 18 hexadecimal, or 10 decimal is equal to 10 octal number, or 20 decimal is equal to 10100 binary number. So 20 decimal number is equal to 10110 binary numbers. Now we'll solve how to solve this one. Before solving, if you not watch my previous videos, please go and watch my all free net videos, because before otherwise it's very difficult to understand. Look at 2 raised to 0 is the bit positions, means what 0th bit position is 1. 2 raised to 1 means first bit position is 2. So this is exactly bit positions. This is 0th bit position, 1 bit position, 2nd bit position, 3rd bit position, this is 4th bit position, like that. Actually these are the bit positions already explained in my previous videos, just go through it. So this is the, these are the bit position and respective values. Now look at 20. I will randomly, I will select, because which one of the following is correct. I will check it one. Let us assume 20. 20 is, you may separate it 2 to the power, that is 16 plus 4 is 20. So you may, 16 is 4th bit position, and 1 is in 3rd bit position, because 2 raised to 4 is 16 and 2 raised to 2 is 4. So 2nd bit position this is. So actually 16 plus 4 is 20. So 2 raised to 4 is 16, 2 raised to 2 is 4. So 4 plus 16 is 20. Okay, this one. Now you write 4th and 2nd. This one I have written wrongly, sorry. 2nd bit position is 1, remaining bits positions are 0. So now look at, this is 0th bit position, 1st bit position, this is 2nd bit position, this is 3rd bit position, this is 4th bit position. So 2nd bit position and 4th bit position, write it 1, remaining all are 0. That is 20. Look at here, this is 10100. This is 2 raised to 4 is 16, 2 raised to 3 is 8, actually this is 0, 2 raised to 2 is 4. So 4 plus 16 is 20. So look at the option 10100. This is the right answer. Which one is correct answer? Okay, you may look at this one. This is 2 raised to 0, 2 raised to 1, 2 raised to 2, 2 raised to 3, 2 raised to 4. 2 raised to 1 is 2 plus 2 raised to 2 is 4, 2 plus 4 is 6, and 2 raised to 3 is 0. Anyhow, 2 raised to 4 is 16. 16 plus 6 is 22. 20 decimal not equal to 22 binary. So definitely it's not equal. You can check it, these A and B also similarly. So option C is right answer. This is shortcut way I have explained. Who are watching first time this video, definitely you feel it's very difficult, but please go through my previous videos and watch all previous based on binary to conversation videos, then definitely you'll get to how to solve this one in easy way. Just write it here, 2 to the power, 2 raised to 0, 2 raised to 1, 2 raised to 2, 2 raised to 3, 2 raised to 4. 2 raised to 4 is 16 and 2 raised to 2 is 4, 16 plus 4 is 20. You will get directly. Wherever you will get a 0, that you consider as 0. Look at this one. 0 is 0. 0, answer is 0. If it is 1, look at the position of the bit. So 2 raised to 2. So second bit position means you will get value is 4. So third bit position, actually it is 0 into this one is all, we'll get 0 only. So fourth bit position 16, 16 plus 4 is 20. So option C is right answer. So look at third question. Which one of the following is correct? This is exactly June 2017 question. Just look at the small difference. This is 16, 18. Here 17, 17. Almost same question, similar question asked. If this is net 2017, that one similar question, instead of 17 they have changed 16. This is small change. That's why I'm telling you, please solve more and more previous questions, then only you will solve this one. Just take it as a homework, as a homework or somewhat you try to practice like these questions. This one similar question. Now we'll move for, this is also one I have given an exercise. Just go through it and try to solve. Or if you get any query, just in comment box or mail me, whatever your query, we'll solve more and more questions future. Next, one more question they asked. Firewall means a software program or a piece of hardware between computer and internet connection. A software program between printer and memory chip. A device to create a file, a fire on the wall, and virus. They have given four options. Firewall, I think non-computer science background students, maybe you feel it's difficult question, but actually it is easy. Firewall is name itself, it suggests you are protecting something. Protecting something means the given four options, you may go through it. Option A and D are protecting something, because viruses, you may heard word, I need to protect the virus and all. For protecting virus, you may feel it is the right answer. But usually for firewall is used for internet purpose or internet connection. This is a software program or a piece of hardware between computer and internet connection. Firewall is a software used to protect the viruses, means internet viruses. It may attack to the PC or personal computers. To protect that one, we will use a firewall. Okay. Actually, second option is software program between printer and memory chip. This is irrelevant to the question. But if you know minimum basic knowledge, you can answer easily. Answer option A. Okay. So this is what is exactly firewall. Firewall is a system designed to prevent unauthorized access to or from private network. You can implement a firewall in either hardware or software form, or a combination of both. Firewalls prevent unauthorized internet users from the accessing private networks connected to the internet, especially intranets. Okay, this is exactly firewall. That is easy question. In fortunate or unfortunate, you may feel it in this KSET exam. In abbreviation, they asked three questions only based on abbreviations. Three questions. Look at. Means what, if you list out all important abbreviations of computer science, just look at, create one word file, list out all abbreviations, means three questions means 6 marks you will get directly based on abbreviations. Just simple, this is PDF is an abbreviation for, this is simple. If you list out all the abbreviations you have, read it again and again, based on this one definitely will solve, because there is no hint, nothing in this type of questions. Directly you just read and write the abbreviations. Just look at PDF, portable document format, actually that one. But here all four options given file, portable document file, this one. So portable directory file or portable document file or portable deleted file or portable domain file, in this option B is right answer. Here there is no hint, there is no nothing, just list out all the abbreviations, important abbreviations in computer science, and definitely you'll get one or two questions based on abbreviations. So one more questions, VoIP. voice over internet protocol, voice on the intranet procedure, wide offer intranet procedure, valid offer in programs. In these questions, just again I am telling you, list out all the abbreviations and read it once or twice. Definitely you'll get one or two questions based on abbreviations. Okay, in these three questions means 6 marks directly you'll get. In DNS means domain name system, this is option D is right answer, here option E is right answer, here option B is right answer. In this simply you will get 6 marks. There is no hint there, nothing, just read it twice or thrice before exam. You can easily answer. Okay, I hope you understood this one. There are 6 questions based on computer in KSET. Based on computer science means 12 marks out of 100. Please, what do you feel, just if you like or dislike, subscribe it to the channel and inform your friends. For your encouragement, I can prepare more and more videos. Thank you for watching.